Owning a 3D printer is no longer a luxury for first adopters and DIY enthusiasts. A steady stream of improvements to open source designs and some help from manufacturers releasing older models under a similar license means better pricing for you. It also means a lot of options and a lot of models that look very similar on paper. Before we get started with our video detailing the best 3D printers on the market, we've included links in the description for each product mentioned, so make sure you check those out to see which one is in your budget range. Starting off with the best overall 3D printer, we have the Maker Select Ultimate. The Monoprice Maker Select Ultimate sets the bar high for budget-friendly 3D printers. Its 20 micron layer resolution is one of the best available for fused filament printers, resulting in prints with smooth sides and excellent detail. It packs in the kind of features you're likely to see on more expensive 3D printers, like an all-metal frame, heated build plate, and support for a wide variety of materials. Despite all that, it will run you just $649.99, although you can often find open box specials for even less. The Maker Ultimate's 20 micron layer resolution is easily its headline feature. It's as much as 5 times more detailed than some of the other printers on our list, and the results are immediately evident. At the highest quality, printed models are almost smooth on the sides, and you're unlikely to see any burrs or bumps, and its print area is 7.8 inches horizontally and 6.8 inches vertically. Print speed suffers as a result of the precise layers. The Maker Ultimate comes out of the box with a 150mm per second speed, but as you dial in the settings, you can push it as high as 300mm per second, although the consistency will suffer a bit as a result. Unlike some of the other printers on this list, the Ultimate is software agnostic, so you can opt for your favorite slicing program or even control it remotely with Raspberry Pi and OctoPrint. Assembly and setup is surprisingly easy, as the Maker Ultimate arrives almost entirely put together. You'll simply need to connect a wire from the back of the frame to the printhead, and then follow the on-screen instructions to level the print bed. Amazon shoppers did note that getting the settings just right for those excellent prints took a few tries, which is to be expected. The print quality impressed the reviewers at Tom's Guide, but they noted the slow print speed was a bit of a letdown. Next up, we have the best dual extruding 3D printer, which goes to the QIDI Technology's dual extruders. QIDI Technology's 3DP QDA1601 takes an older replicator design and adds a number of high-end improvements, like a heated build platform and a completely enclosed chassis. Most notably, however, the QIDI Technology 3DP supports two extruders on its printhead for double the fun. The two extruders work together to form a single print, but can operate with different settings and timings. That means you can easily print in two colors, but the fun really starts when you combine two different materials. You can print a rigid component inside a flexible component so that it only bends one direction, or print supports in a dissolvable material that you can easily melt away, saving you time snipping and sanding. Buyers on Amazon noted that the QIDI technology requires a bit of assembly, but nothing too complicated. It comes with a number of pre-assembled components that need to be put together. If you have any trouble getting up and running, the QIDI technology customer support was helpful in resolving issues and helping with setup. Up next, we have the best 3D printer for families, which goes to the Flashforge Finder. The Flashforge Finder focuses on easy setup and everyday use. Its fun design and easy-to-use software are great for exploring the world of 3D printing or letting your kids run wild. It's hard to end up with a bad print. You should have no issue setting up the Finder the first time, and it comes with a number of features that help with consistency and access. There's a process for automatically leveling the build plate before use, and you can slide the plate out after a print to easily remove it. Plus, all of the hot components are enclosed, so there's little to no risk of accidental burns or melted plastic. The build area is a bit on the small side, measuring just 5.5 inches horizontally and vertically, but that should be more than enough to bring your smaller ideas to life or print in multiple pieces. Its 100 micron layer resolution isn't terribly impressive, instead falling in line with most other 3D printers. It only works with PLA, the most common 3D printing filament, so if you know you want to use other materials, you'll want to look elsewhere, like the Monoprice Select Mini 3D V2. Amazon buyers generally agreed that, while the Finder is a little basic, it offers an excellent entryway into 3D printing with little risk of screwing up your prints or burning your hands. A number of them recommended an external filament holder, particularly if you buy third-party filament, and designs are readily available in any number of shapes and sizes. Next, we have the best small 3D printer, which goes to the Monoprice Select Mini 3D V2. If you're just looking to print out smaller projects, the Monoprice Select Mini 3D V2 is an excellent choice. its compact design still supports a comfortable build size, with up to 4.7 inches vertically and horizontally, which should be enough to print out replacement parts for your toys, or a fun trinket for your friends. It also scores high points for easy setup and use. It comes out of the box, fully assembled and pre-calibrated, so you don't have to level the bed or install any hardware yourself. It still manages to check a number of boxes that some high-end printers don't, including a heated build plate, color display, Wi-Fi connectivity, and an all-metal chassis. The major downside to the Select 3D Mini V2 is speed. At just 55 millimeters per second, it's almost a third of the print speed of the larger Monoprice, and well below most of the other options on the list. The upshot is that, with such a small build plate, you're unlikely to print anything that's going to take multiple days. And for our last pick, we have the best DIY 3D printer kit, which goes to the Anycubic i3 Mega. If you're willing to spend a little more time setting up your printer the first time, there are dozens of kits based on designs from the open source RepRap project. The most popular model is the Prusa i3, and the model we've selected from the Anycubic boasts a metal frame and an extra large build area at just over 8 inches in every direction. There are some notable advantages to building from your own kit. The open source design is compatible with the widest variety of slicing software options, plenty of room to tweak settings and customize speed and detail to your liking, and readily available upgrades and replacement parts. Amazon buyers notice success with a variety of filament types and print resolutions, as well as a design flaw where the cord at the top of the extruder can come unplugged. Fortunately, when there's a problem, there are plenty of pieces you can print to solve it. Ultimately, a Prusa kit is a better option for someone who wants to take matters into their own hands. It's not going to work perfectly the first time, but ironing out the kinks makes a great project, and it will grow with you as you learn more about 3D printing and maker projects. So that sums up our top 3D printers of 2019. We hope you enjoyed. If you did, please leave a like on the video, and if you're new here, hit that subscribe button. Until next time, have a great day.